Well, something I found in Leningrad. They say it once belonged to a cousin of Ivan the Terrible.
But don't you believe it?
Thank you. I love it anyway. Where would you like to begin?
At the top.
First of all, your winter lecture tour is shaping up great.
Mm-hmm.
More responses from colleges and universities than ever before.
Good.
You're a star.
Was there ever any doubt?
There's a letter here from Dean Rusk. Would you like me to read it?
No.
Okay. Office of Secretary of State, Washington, D.C. Dear Norman, I want to take this opportunity to commend you and the Saturday Review on the fine work being done. You're performing great service and stimulating serious thought about the overriding questions of the atomic age. May you carry on for many more years. Sincerely yours, Dean Rusk.
That's very nice of him. I'll dictate a reply later. What's next?
Hey, quiet.
Not bad.
Norman, I know you're not feeling well, so...
Thank you a lot for making time for this lunch. No, I, honest to God, I appreciate your help. It's been on my mind for a while. Since before you left. 60 bits of briefcase, please. I mean, I'm not anti-science.
No.
But damn it, something has to be done to set the standards for experimenting on live animals, and I don't see that being approached. Thanks twice. Good.
I'm with you, Clipper, whatever you say.
Well, the point is that these corporations have a completely free hand to experiment.
Brings me up.
Race you back to the office.
What?
Race you back.
Well, I'm going to beat you.
Yeah.
You know I will.
You haven't yet.
Norman, because I let you win because you're the editor.
Okay. On your mark.
No, Norman.
Get set.
I don't want to do this.
Go!
Officer, this can be explained.
Yeah, sure it can.
Norman, will you tell the officer it's a joke? Norman, will you tell the officer this is...
The name is Bob, Buster, and this is my briefcase. I can prove it because I put $5 right under this box. See?
Officer, this man is joking. I'm telling you, this is a setup. This man's my boss. He is an incorrigible spoofer.
Oh, cuz, I'll get you for this.
What?
This is a setup.
Norman, what is it?
Well, I ain't safe here.
Bedroom was on the second floor of the hotel in Moscow. We kept the windows open. Diesel trucks kept going by all night. He must have inhaled a lot of fumes. In fact, I remember feeling nauseated every morning. Then at the airport, a big jet swung around in front of us. We caught the exhaust point blank. Could it be the hydrocarbons?
Swallow.
Bill?
How does Ellen feel?
Fine. No problem with her.
Well, it's possible it could affect you and not her. But if it is the heavy metal poisoning, the blood tests will show it right away. Well, let me see.
Hurts?
I know.
At
2. All right. Tell me about the illness during the early part of your trip.
What can I tell you? The fever went to 103.
Strep infection?
It was never identified. It left as soon as it came.
And what about the trip itself?
Frantic. One frustrating problem after another. Follow-ups all over the place. Late night paperwork, meetings. Seems as though this whole year has been like that.
Yeah. I've watched you. You've been under a great deal of strain.
Adrenal exhaustion. Could that be what this is all about?
What? Thank you. SED 88. That's not good.
What's a SED?
Well, it's something like a blood count, only a little more complicated. I'm going to put you into Mount Sinai. I want a complete workup on you.